Welcome back. Here on this video, we will be going to see how we can add the IAM role to the EC2 instance and why it is important. As you can see here, we haven't created yet any IAM role, hence it is not attached to this instance. So let's start using IAM roles for our EC2 instance. I'm going to connect to my EC2 instance. As we know this already now that we can SSH or can use EC2 instance connect if you wanted to. I will use again EC2 instance connect because it's easy method and can directly connect to the instance in my web browser, and we are in our instance here. So as we can see, we are EC2 user @ the private type. Now we can just do some Linux commands here. As we are in a Linux terminal right now in the cloud, okay, so we will type some IAM commands. For example, AWS IAM list user. Here is some problem. I think I missed something. Okay. Oh, got it. I missed that S at the ends of users. Okay. We'll type it again. AWS IAM list users and hit the enter. And if we do so, it says unable to locate credentials. You can configure credentials by using AWS configure. As we don't have any option to run AWS configure for now to configure the credentials and specify an access ID, a secret access key and a region name. But this is not a good thing to show the access ID and a secret access key into the EC2 instance here on terminal, because if we run AWS configure and enter our personal details onto this EC2 instance, then anyone else in our account could again connect to our EC2 instance and can retrieve the value of this credential in our instance, which is not good at all. Instead of doing this, we can do one best thing, that is we have to use IAM roles. We can create an IAM role as we haven't created it so far. So let's go back into the IAM and then go on left pane to select the roles. We can create here the role. We will go for it and click on EC2 to add the permissions on it. And now we'll search for IAM read only policy on filter policies section. Okay. Select this policy and now we'll go to add the tag for this role. Here we will add the key value pairs to add to our roles. Name the key and read only role for value, then go for next to review all. Under review option, we'll give here the role name, and that is IAM read only, and we will go for the next to create this role. Okay, we have created the new IAM roles with read only permission. So we are going to attach this role onto our EC2 instance to provide it with credentials. Okay, so how we can do this? For this, we can go into security or can see here in details also. As you can see, there is no IAM role right now onto our instance. Now we can go to the action, security, and then modify IAM role. Here we have to choose an IAM role. As you can see here, the newly created IAM read-only role, select this role and click on save to attach this IAM role into our Linux instance. Okay, we have done here as we have attached the IAM role to our instance, and we can see here as well the IAM role attached to instance IAM read-only. Why we have added this, do you know? After adding this, we can get the commands answered successfully without providing the unwanted things, which is dangerous and not good. If want to see the effect of this is, then we'll run again AWS IAM list users and press enter. And we are getting response around the users from IAM. As we can see, without run the command AWS configure, we get the response which we are not happened before added the IAM role. Hope you understand this. We just attach the IAM role and run this command and it works. Alright, if you want to cross check, and then I will go back into this role and detach this permission. You can see now it is gone. Here is not a IAM read only role which we have created, it is detached. Okay, now we will run the command again and here we are getting an access denied. So the role is really linked now to the EC2 instance, and this is how we provide AWS credentials to our EC2 instances only. through IAM roles. Got it now? Okay. Now we will go back to IAM and attach a policy to this role and go back to IAM read only to attach this policy. Now go back to the Instance Connect terminal and then rerun the command. Hit the enter and here we are getting the response. That is it, which is what we want. So this is very important to understand why we use IAM roles for your EC2 instances. I am ending this here and we'll see you on my next video. Till then, have a good day and bye bye.